I surf as regularly as possible, and my working life fuses travel and local surfing. And when I'm based at home in Cornwall, you dictate a working day around the tide. Each day you'll try and dedicate a few hours to surfing, and the timing of that will be dependent on three things: the state of the tide, the local wind conditions, and the quality of the sandbanks at the beach where I live, which alternate over the weeks and months. And by living there and understanding the place, you get a real intrinsic feel for when to be in the sea at the right time. Timing is everything in sport and life, and surfing particularly, because you're dealing with a fluid environment, a liquid space. When I was younger, surfing was much more about bravado, and I felt like I had to win contests or stand out. But as I've travelled more and become older, for me, surfing is about being in rhythm. It's about being in rhythm with the landscape, with your life at that time. As the travel got more regular, I noticed that surfing was a big element, and it was the commercially driven element because that's what would allow it to be funded. But really, it was the buzz of danger in exploration by going somewhere that is known to be volatile. And then finding out that people are the same everywhere, but there are always stories of ingenuity and entrepreneurship and positives in the most degraded, devastating contexts. And surfers weave between things. And there's a certain type of movement I've learned through dancing on a surfboard that I bring into my head through travel and writing. And they work together quite closely. It's the brilliant corners, it's the cobwebs of the world that I've found a surfboard is curved out. And when you turn that right angle into a curve, it's a big ball, and then there's more to explore. And you want to keep going back because it then becomes a never-ending obsession to figure out more of the things going on and look at more of the landscape. And for me, there's the element of meeting people, but I consider the landscape as big a character as anything. You never master surfing because the environment that you're interacting with is too liquid and unpredictable, and you never get the same wave twice, so you never have an opportunity to perfect something in surfing. Waves are unpredictable, and life is unpredictable. And if you're obsessed with a sport based on waves, your life is fully unpredictable. And the beauty of surfing is that you're dealing with this viscous, fluid environment, and the fact that it's constantly changing means you can never repeat something. So you go back to the same location regularly to ride waves, but that location looks different every second of every day and looks different every week of every year. And that sends you on a journey within the sport and within your own life. Traveling with a surfboard is just outstanding. When you take that surfboard somewhere where it's unfamiliar, A, you have this artisan tool that you feel comfortable with, and B, you attract a type of audience that have a preconception, and then when you prove that you're not taking advantage of them, the way they light up is really incredible. When you take surfing away from the coast, it's quite exotic. Surfing on the coast is quite familiar. For me, I like to keep surfing exotic. It sounds rather frivolous, but keep surfing interesting, to take surfing to places where it doesn't currently exist, to use surfing in relationships with other art forms that haven't talked to surfing yet, like jazz music and improvisation and bespoke artwork on surfboards. These are areas that haven't talked much in the past. When you talk between these kind of different scenes, where they cross over, it's almost like the feeling of riding a good wave. There's turbulence and adrenaline and creativity.